These shoes, Italian made, handcrafted, but still just shoes. This jacket, 100% wool, tailor made, but still just a jacket. This dress, liquid gold, pure silk, but just a dress. The limited edition, Nanam by La Duma. Iconic design, steeped in style, and so much more than just fashion. The more you use it, the more valuable it becomes. For him, for her, saving has never looked this good.
Thank you. thousands of miles of away, away, away.
The Campanile was erected to commemorate the landing of the 1820 settlers and more or less the place where they landed. There was a competition in 1920, but the winner, the design was too expensive, and eventually local architect Mac Williams was appointed, and the building was completed 3 years late in 1923. And then in 1936, carillon of 23 bells ranging from middle C to B flat was added.
The Campanile as an iconic tourism icon for the city hadn't been maintained for a while. So what gave rise to the restoration was really firstly to look at how can we modernize it, but also how can we prevent it from being a health hazard in terms of maintenance. The Campanile is strategically located at the start of Route 67. You'll remember that Route 67 runs through the heart of the city. For the MBDA, it's become a very, in fact for the city, it's become one of the most visited tourism assets that we have.
So the upgrade had two significant objectives, three actually. One was fixing the building that was about to fall apart, which was the most important one. But while we were given that mandate, we wanted it to do two other things. We wanted it to showcase a new democracy. So the building celebrates 100 years of settler presence in this metro. So it is a colonial building. But there's a new story associated with the Campanile because it is the start of Route 67, which tells the story about Nelson Mandela, his contribution to the struggle, 67 years that he worked for our democracy, in parallel to the history of our metro. So it's not only his story, it's all of our stories that start in this very precinct. So we wanted the building to be able to do that. So where it will work economically is for creatives to have the opportunity to showcase their talents. And already in the precinct behind me is a mural that was commissioned by one of the young creatives in the metro as part of Route 67. So it was an opportunity to earn as a creative practitioner, as an artist and sculptor in the precinct. And in the building itself, there are opportunities through the exhibition space for more of that to happen. The tourism will benefit because now the start of Route 67 is fabulous. We'd like to think it's world class. It's something unique to see. It's exciting because you can bring new people in that couldn't have gotten to the top before because the lift makes it able, wheelchair or disabled people, physically impaired, to access the top of the building. And you can have a new audience coming to the building. The building has its own heritage and its own history, which was celebrated with 23 magnificent bells. So the bells are the most beautiful objects of art in the building. But we wanted to add to that. We wanted to create an opportunity for the creative industry to be involved as well. And hence, on every floor that's available, there is an exhibition that can move and change during the course of the year that will give an opportunity to creatives in the city to showcase who they are or what they're doing, or to be used as a celebration of a particular event. So for example, for Women's Day, we could have an exhibition around women. For Youth Day, we could have an exhibition around youth to make the building function.
We also try to include elements of surprise to make it a very interesting journey for the visitor.
The Ghost Bells is really about an opportunity for delight for children, and I'm sure adults will enjoy it too, but it enables you to understand how the bells are working by pressing the keys of an imaginary keyboard in the same way that works with the bells themselves. It shows you how the bells are working because the bells, remember, are hidden away. So the Ghost Bells are imitation bells, and each bell will light up as you press the relevant key for that bell.
We put on step 67 a stainless steel plate with an outline of Madiba to signify the contribution that he made, And on the viewing level, we made a huge stainless steel window where one can step beyond the wall of the campanile to be 300 millimeters outside of the wall and have a wonderful view of the harbor.
It also brings people together. It brings people from all walks of life. So we can now have a concert around the campanile bells, collaborating with musos from anywhere in the world. And that we feel is very unique, and it differentiates the city, and it's really one of those what you can call added advantages in terms of tourism.
The start of Route 67 is very important for this metro because we have the honor of bearing Nelson Mandela's name, and this is a product that a tourist could come and walk to celebrate that. And the start of the building actually enables that to happen. So it is about a new heritage being formed. So we acknowledge the old, heritage, the colonial story of 100 years of colonial presence, but we are focused on transforming that to what is the new heritage. And the new heritage is Route 67 and our current issues and our current democracy and the challenges we face now and how we transform that. And they are about the economic challenges and the social transformation challenges.
Nelson Mandela Bay, a city frequently bypassed and often overlooked, yet loved by those who have been drawn back time and again to its friendly shores. Those who are proud to call Nelson Mandela Bay home. But more than a beloved home or holiday destination, we believe this city is South Africa's best kept secret. We believe it's a city brimming with untold potential and possibility. Do you?
I think we all love Nelson Mandela Bay. You know, it's some people call it a 10-minute city. It's a city with so much diversity in what you can do. It's not a mega city. It's livable, it's workable. I think there's a sense of community in this town.
Project Nelson Mandela Bay is a private good citizen initiative with a bold vision of making Nelson Mandela Bay the greatest city in South Africa.
It's about civil society getting behind, propelling the city to move forward, to develop further.
Project NMB is not primarily an organization or a CSI initiative, but rather a logical business intervention, driven by a network of visionaries, connectors, lobbyists, change agents, and passionate citizens who have taken up the call to be the change.
I'm passionate about promoting Port Elizabeth, or our name of Nelson Mandela Bay, which is an iconic name and which we need to wear with a great deal of pride.
We're all passionate about our city in one way or the other. And as Project NMB, we're trying to harness all of those energies towards fulfilling one goal, unity of purpose. So as long as we're all passionate about a city, we'll find a space to get involved.
Project NMB began in 2013 and was later registered as a non-profit company. A core steering committee was established to manage the project and oversee the appointed task teams working on projects in key development sectors, which currently include Clean City, Safe City, Connected City, Smart City iGEMS, 12 active months. The project has built strong relationships with third-party organizations, network partners, and advisors both in and outside the city, who offer personal and corporate equity.
We've seen a lot of enthusiasm from the public, from business, from different stakeholders getting involved. What we've seen is crystallizing the vision and really charting a way forward for the teams to really function and really mobilize. And some of them have gone beyond what we thought they'd achieved by now.
All of us project teams or sub-project teams are finding that a lot of determination is required. A lot of people involved are people who have day-to-day jobs as well. So it means that time is always going to be an issue. So we're going to need to raise financial support.
It needs to grow with a solid business base. And if we're going to work within business principles and business ethics and business plans, those things need money. And we are asking corporates to step forward, because we need to come forward. We need to pay it forward.
What we're saying is, demonstrate your passion and love for your city by getting involved. For some organizations, it might be they give their time, they may give their staff, they give their wisdom, and some might give financial resources. But a project like this cannot sustain itself without any support.
And we need to make this place work. This is about good citizenship, nothing more.
We invite you to be part of the journey forward to unlock the true potential of Nelson Mandela Bay, South Africa's best kept secret.
Feed the poor till they are narrow, rich no more.